started in September with auditions. Once classes began in October, the road to play ball had begun. All the dancers had lots to learn. It was exciting to think that all over the ad hoc region, in gyms, lunchrooms, and town halls, NHDI dancers were taking their first steps toward the event of the year. Finally, at the end of May, Performance Week was here. Each class came to the Arts Center after school to try out their dances on the stage. Final costume adjustments were made. It was a very exciting time. Just seeing the auditorium and all the empty seats helped the dancers to imagine what it would be like when the theater was full of people. On Friday afternoon, the orchestra arrived and we had our first full rehearsal with music, singers, costumes, and lights. When the curtain opened on Friday evening, you could feel the excitement in the air. Play ball was about to begin.
Thank you. rushes in, he scoops up the line drive, he throws it to first base, and then he zooms down to second base, he takes the catch, he makes the tag, it's a double play. Wait a minute, what's this? He screams down the third baseline, he beats the runner, he makes the tag, it's a triple play, and the crowd goes wild!
Hi there. I was just warming up a bit, you know. I guess I was warming up my imagination a little bit too. Hey, baseball, that's my game. Well, it's getting out in springtime after a long, cold winter. It's kids playing while the sun sets, and there's just not enough light even to see the ball. Your first real Major League Baseball game, and the smells of peanuts and hot dogs and all the colors of the field. You know, sometimes I like to imagine my dream baseball game. Now, of course, there's always sunshine. And I'm sitting in the box seats on first base line in Fenway Park in Boston or Royal Stadium in Kansas City. And I have in one hand a hot dog from Detroit. And in the other, I have a soda from Milwaukee, and I'm surrounded by Baltimore fans, and we're waiting for that operatic vendor from Al Lang Field in St. Petersburg to come by. He sings East Side, West Side in a ringing baritone. You know, that's the kind of dream you remember best. But it's all not dreams and imagination. It's more than that. It's real and it's physical. It takes ready hands and strong legs and wrists and heart and the whole god darn body working together. Now, I've got a team here that's ready to show you how the body works. Now, let me get my scorecard. Okay, here we are. My team is the New Hampshire Dance Institute, and the dancers from the Jack Levine School are going to take you right to the heart of America. Fortunately, we have a color school here to show us how that blood gets moving around.
come down. All that blood squishing around. Talk about your pressure in your doctor's say. Cholesterol and tumor stress will make you pay.
It's too much. You don't work out. You just get tired and you fill out. You push your fire and your energy grow. And you push yourself to the hard and tough to grow. Did you find the turn outside of a nice solid car? I'm not.
constructing here wouldn't get anywhere without a fast pair of feet. And fortunately, we found some of the fastest feet in New Hampshire at South Meadow School. Just watch. Thank you. would be a pretty boring place if everybody looked the same. But fortunately, you live in a world where everybody looks a little bit different. Now, we're going to construct for you a handsome face here, with eyes and ears by the Westmoreland School, and nose and smile by the Marlborough School.
You don't know how much I really love you. You don't know how much I really care.
Thank you.
would take off our hats and have a look at a good hair day at the Wells School.
Connect to your backbone. Connect to your head bone.
just about done it. We've constructed ourselves a baseball player. Strong and sure-footed, energetic, alert. There's only one thing missing at this point, something quite human. It's not physical, you can't touch it, but it's certainly there. It's that thing that burns inside every one of us.
Thank you.
to think about it a lot. And whenever I'm at a game, it's not just that game that I'm seeing. It's as though all the ghosts who've ever watched or played the game were there too. I mean, the sounds haven't changed much through the years. In baseball parks and backyards and vacant lots all through America, you still have the rap of the bat as it meets the ball and the cries of the infielders. And the umpire's calling, strike three, you're out. It's like it's some sort of eternal summer where time isn't measured in years, but in innings. And the generations just circle the base paths and dust rises for 60 years as people round third and slide into home. I like to read about baseball, too. Stories of hope and the power of a dream. Now, this is a story like that. It's about a young fellow they call the Kid. And it begins on a cool evening in a small town. The Kid worked for years for this moment, and everything was set for his big trip south to training camp. He said his goodbyes, he had his favorite bat. But now that it was really time to leave, he began to have second thoughts. Grown. He remembered all the years of practice, and most of all, how much he loved to play the game. The next thing he knew, he was waiting for a train headed south. And as he looked around at his fellow travelers, he wondered about them. Did they each have a story to tell? Well, they certainly seemed to have important places to go.
Pack your bag and pack your kit, and the others won't be slow.
Don't know where we're going, but gee jeepers, here I go.
Oh,
crocodiles and palm trees, papa breezes. This is sure different from home. But what was most important to the kid was that he was finally here at the official training camp for his favorite big league team, the Hannibal Hawks. Now the real work could begin. Calisthenics, drills, workouts, practice games, all in the hot Florida sun. Oh, the competition. It seemed like everyone there was as hungry for a chance to make it as he was. Everyone was trying to be noticed by the people who made the decisions.
I'm a little bit.
the story, gotta get the story on the kid. Extra, extra, you can read all about it. And I wrote my story, wrote my story, wrote my story on the kid.
This time, he'd become a full-fledged member of the Hawks baseball team. Everything was hinging on this final game. The baseball fans were out in force, and tickets for this important game were becoming scarce. The local scouters saw their opportunity.
Anybody need a ticket? Anybody need a ticket for the team this game? I got you, and I want to go through. God, I want to take the boat.
Thank you.
anyone who managed to get a ticket for this game considered himself really lucky. And somehow everyone knew that they were about to see baseball history being made. As the kid began to warm up on the field, he could hear the excited crowd beginning to fill the stands.
Yeah.
strike was almost ready to start. He took a deep breath as the umpires entered the field to inspect the lines and get the teams organized and ready to play. When they gave the signal, it would be time to begin.
In that heated world of baseball, there's a center of tranquility, a single source of
seemed to get a hit, and the crowd began to be restless when he came up to bat. He fanned out twice and was called out on strikes the third time. Maybe he was just trying too hard. Then, in the top of the ninth, the opponent scored a run, and now here it was, the bottom of the ninth, and the Hawks were losing. Sam Jones made it to second, but then Zeke Nelson popped out to left field, and Rusty Dalton was called out on strikes. That left one more out when the kid stepped up to the plate. All his dreams were riding on this turn at bat, and as he caught a glint in the pitcher's eye, his doubts began to whisper to him again.
Thank you.
Thank you.